Again this year, you placed yourself in a position of conflict at the cabinet table around the WE charity decision to award that student grant program to the charity, knowing at least that your wife had been paid by the organization for speaking, your brother and your mother. Do you have an ethical blind spot? Like, how does this keep happening to you?
Well, first of all, this year, the promise we made to Canadians was to have their back, to be there and to look for as many different ways of helping people who need help because of this pandemic as we possibly could.
Yeah, what does that have to do with this decision, though?
Well, because this decision was about supporting young people who volunteer in their communities with a grant that would be administered by this organization. Now, as I said at the time, I should have recused myself because of the optics, and I'm sorry that I didn't. And yes, absolutely, I would have done things differently.
Yeah.
But my focus, and my focus every single step of the way this year, was getting the help out to Canadians that they needed.
I understand that, but as a result of your blind spot, no one got the help. The student grants didn't happen. The WE charity organization fell apart.
Those student grants didn't happen. We didn't give bonuses or grants to kids who were volunteering. But we got out the Canada Emergency Student Response Benefit. We got record numbers of youth employment opportunities for the summer jobs. We were able to help kids and young people in a lot of ways.
I know, but you do understand that your inability to see this as a problem, because that's what you're telling me, it was you couldn't see this, which to me is surprising, frankly, that resulted in kids not being able to use that volunteer grant. Do you get that?
And that's why I regret it. And that's why I came out here and said, you know, when you make a mistake, you own up to it and you try and make it better. And that's exactly what we've done. I didn't know how much they got paid by WE, but I should have. I made a mistake on this. I deeply regret it and I take responsibility for it.
How do you make sure that this doesn't happen again to you? That is there someone helping you see where the potential problems are in terms of your conflict?
The way that we approached this issue, like many other issues, is how we help Canadians. And of course, in this situation, there was a communications challenge. There was an optics challenge. There was no conflict of interest here. There was absolutely no conflict.
Ethically, it wasn't. It didn't look. It wasn't appropriate.
It doesn't look.
No. Ethically,
good.
It wasn't appropriate.
And that's what I admitted here.
Yeah.
Because yes, there are connections.
Yeah.
But there was no conflict here. There was no profiting from this situation.
The government was in the midst of your biggest economic response for this country since the Depression, and you lost your finance minister, Bill Morneau.
It's the right time for a new finance minister to deliver on that plan for the long and challenging road ahead. That's why I'll be stepping down as finance minister and as member of parliament for Toronto Centre.
Did you lose him because you two were at odds over policy? Did you lose him because you felt he was compromised on the WE charity?
No, as Bill said, he was already looking towards new challenges ahead of next year's election, the potential election next year. I'm sorry to see him take on new challenges, but I know we're going to be very well served if he gets that job at the OECD.
You then prorogued Parliament, which stopped the committee investigation into the WE controversy. Liberals then filibustered in committees in Parliament in order to prevent opposition parties and the public from seeing documents around your family's payments in relation to that charity. Did you prorogue Parliament to shut that down?
No, we prorogued Parliament because we were in the middle of a pandemic, and obviously the opposition will and can continue to focus on whatever they wanted. We stayed focused on Canadians, and the throne speech we gave just a year ago was no longer relevant for what Canadians were going through, and we needed a new
throne speech. You could have prorogued at any time, though. I mean, you understand people might be cynical looking at when the timing of that prorogation.
People are cynical about politics in general. People are skeptical, and my responsibility as a government is delivering for Canadians in ways that matter to them. And right now in this pandemic, they wanted to know that we have their backs, which we do. They wanted to know we were focused on delivering for them, on keeping them safe, on delivering a plan that would not only take us through this pandemic, but bring us back stronger after it. And that was our focus.
But they're also cynical when they see politicians do things that become self-serving.
But we are doing this to help Canadians, and that's what they understood.